Rich is here to review some movies.
And to share the love. Why not? It's Friday.
Yeah, that's right. I get to see free movies all the time. Well, why not you?
Get to see Mrs. Arsh are getting killed. We can give these boys a better chance than we ever had.
In a movie that says Oscar bait all over it, a young boy and his working class family experience the tumultuous late 1960s in Belfast. 98 minutes of PG-13 rated drama that you could see for free at a preview next Tuesday, the 9th at 7 p.m. at the Megaplex Jordan Commons. If you're available and you want to go, head to fox13now.com, click on the contest tab at the top, and enter to see Belfast with a good email address. And then it would be helpful if you, like, you know, checked your email now and again. Sorry. Anyway. Now, let's talk Marvel's Eternals. Check it out.
Throughout the years, we have never interfered.
And they so did interfere. Now, suffice it to say that Eternals had a lot of heavy lifting to do, follow a tough act in the form of the wildly successful MCU, wherein even the lowest rated movie still made bank, and then tie into that whole cinematic universe while still having its own story, give us the origins of 10 new heroes, give them all some screen time, introduce new villains, and allow director Chloe Zhao to do what she does, focus on characters and relationships in a superhero flick, which requires that things ultimately gotta blow up real good. She does a valiant job of balancing all this, I think. The complaints I've heard, I think, are oftentimes conflicting. I think Marvel, frankly, listened to the complaints about its formulaic previous movies, and then gave us something different, and now we're annoyed it's not the same thing. No, not everything is explained, and we don't get adequate time with everyone and every new development. But I think that's what future movies and crossovers are for. If everything was in one movie, there'd be no need to tell more of a story in another movie. And held my interest. I was entertained, as Dan says. I was introduced to a whole lot of new stuff. It gave me a taste for even more stuff on the horizon. It told its own story, and it did it all in a beautiful, thoughtful package. Not necessarily a love story, but a story certainly about love. Love versus loyalty, duty over doing the honorable thing. Is it the best movie in the MCU? No. But is it rotten? No. I urge you to check it out for yourself. I frankly think you will be pleasantly surprised. And certainly, because it's a Marvel movie, stay to the end, very end, for two, a mid and an end credit scene. Now, if you're not looking to go out to theaters, you want to stay at home, that's fine. Tom Hanks is staying at home with you as Finch.
You see, I'm developing something interesting.
Giant leap of faith.
Now, if you can speak, tell me something about you.
Robots must protect dog.
Yep, Tom Hanks in Wall-E. No, wait, not Wall-E. In Castaway. Oh, wait, no. Castaway? No, it's Finch. Pretty much alone, talking to pets and inanimate objects on a trash planet with a robot who learns about our human ways. But if anyone can pull it off, it's Hanks, and he does, although sometimes you end up relating to and feel more for the robot than for Hanks as Finch. He's a bit of a curmudgeon. But when it comes time for Hanks to shine, he certainly does, as does the whole movie. If anything works against Finch as a whole, it's that we've seen a lot of this kind of thing before in Wall-E and in countless other post-apocalyptic flicks, and even a lot more of it with Hanks himself in Castaway. There's a whole been here, seen this kind of thing that hangs over Finch. It's certainly not a bad film, and it goes down easy due to our familiarity with all the tropes that it, you know, has out there, but it also doesn't really bring anything new to it. As it is, it's a competent rehashing. I think it's a retelling of stories that we're already pretty familiar with. Finch is 2 hours of sci-fi drama that is available through Apple TV today. So again, you don't have to leave home to get this one, but you do have to have Apple TV.
Mm. Which is free in some circumstances.
Mm. Like, I want to see it. It looks good.
Like is if it? I borrow your login and password.
Yes, but we would never do that dishonest thing.
No.
We would never do that.
That ain't
no,
right.
No. What is it? What is your
I know. We'll talk later. Okay.
You can tell me.
Can three be logged in at the same time?